let's take a look at a project where we can start to add some redirects and explore this feature of Netlify. So we have a simple site here. It may be familiar from another mission. It's the Vaporium. It's a fictional e-commerce site. We've got a homepage here. We have a store page. Actually, it's a product page here on the store URL. There's also a blog, which just has a couple of example posts in here that we could go and explore on blog and then the name of the post. And there's also an About Us page, which doesn't exist yet. We've just got an About URL in the navigation. Nothing behind that at the moment. We'll come to that shortly. The code for this is just a simple set of HTML. This is something that I generated earlier on, and in later stages we'll look at that static site generator, but for the moment all we care about are the resources that we're serving. So we have an index.html file, we have a few folders like for the store page, which also has a file, and so on and so forth. So it's a fairly simple pre-generated set of assets that we want to start to embellish and add some redirects to. Wouldn't it be nice, for instance, if we could start to add redirects for other URLs to different places? So perhaps we could have something like latest take us straight through, which doesn't exist at the moment, take us straight through perhaps to the latest news on the blog page. Well, as it stands, the project is just HTML, so there's no server configuration for redirects or proxying or rewrites or any of that, but we need to be able to have that configuration. What kind of thing might we like? Well, let's actually make a little redirects file here so that we can start experimenting and thinking about what we might want to create. Well, we did just say, what about having the latest URL pass through to the blog? Wouldn't it be nice if we could just write something like that? Well, this is nice and descriptive, and indeed this is all we need to start to add redirects configuration to the Netlify CDN. If I save that as this file underscore redirects and send that to Netlify at the root of my generated content, so at the root of my published directory, then I would configure Netlify to serve this. Let's have a look at doing that. There's a few ways that we could add this site to Netlify in another mission that you'll perhaps have seen as connecting a site to Netlify using Git. Rather than leaning on Git, which I must admit is my preferred way to work, we're just going to be pushing these assets to Netlify through a deploy command. We need for that the Netlify CLI. Now, from the Netlify docs, you can get all the information you need about the Netlify CLI. This is installed via NPM, so you can run this command to install the CLI, and that will give you globally access to this command, the Netlify command, or NTL is an alias for short. So I've been ahead and I've installed that already, and now I'm going to make use of it. But before I do that, I'm going to add a tiny bit of configuration to our project so that Netlify knows how to deploy that. So I'm going to create a new file called netlify.toml, and this is the standard configuration for any Netlify project. And I'm going to add to that just one chunk of configuration. So I'm going to let Netlify know in our build infrastructure what to deploy. So what directory to publish. And in this case, in actual fact, I'm just going to publish the directory we're in. That's all I'm going to add. And now I'm going to run Netlify init to create a new Netlify project. And it's going to ask me, would I like to connect this to GitHub so I can have continuous integration? I'm actually just going to do this as a manual deploy. So we're just going to push the code that we have here, the HTML that we've generated. I'm going to choose the team I want to be at this site to be a part of. I'll just take the default name. And there we go. So now it's created a new site for me. So now I can run Netlify deploy. And I can even add the production flag. And that will do a push to Netlify, send the assets that are here in my project to the CDN, and then it will give me a URL for that. So we can take a look at that now. Okay, great. So our site now is there, it's hosted. We can navigate around, and hopefully our redirect that we created, latest, now indeed does redirect to blog. Let's just look at that one more time. Latest redirects us to blog. So in doing this, what we've done is we've created a very simple site, we've added a Netlify redirects file, configuration file, we've created the site on Netlify and pushed it to Netlify so that then we can start configuring that further. There is another way that we could add redirects. So this redirects configuration, this needs to live in our published directory, and that's the root directory of this particular project. We can also add the redirects directly to the netlify.toml. So let's just do that quickly as well. So the syntax for that is with toml format, we're adding something to the redirects array. And this is a little bit more explicit. I think it's a little bit more descriptive than the underscore redirects file. This says which URL we're going from. So that was the latest. And where do we want that to redirect to? And that was blog. So this configuration is exactly the same as this underscore redirects configuration file. They'll have exactly the same result. It should be noted that the first rule that Netlify encounters when it's deploying the site is the one that it'll use. So the order of preference, it works down however many URLs we have here, and it will catch the first one and redirect there. And then it will go to the netlify.toml file and work down the list until it finds a hit. The first match it finds is the redirect that will get applied. And by default, you'll notice that I'm not specifying what kind of redirect here. We could be specifying an HTTP status code, such as a 301 for a permanent redirect or a 302 for a found redirect, more of an ephemeral redirect on the CDN. By default, Netlify applies a 302 if it finds no status there at all. But in a later stage, we'll start looking at different things we could do by applying different status codes in our redirects.